Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
Here in Knoxville, Tennessee, at Neyland Stadium, that's where our college football action set to begin. McGrath
has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep to open up the ball game. Here we go, folks.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
LSU's coaching staff, they know they've got a star wide receiver. They know it's going to be a hostile environment. With that, we went to practice this week, Kirk. They had a crowd noise pumped up pretty good getting them ready for this game.
Yeah, they've done everything that they can do to get this offense ready for a tough environment. They had the crowd noise all week long, making it tough to communicate for the quarterback and his receivers. Now it's here. Now it's the game, and we'll see if all that preparation pays off. One thing we know for sure, they want to get the football into the hands of this receiver early and often if they want to win this game.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 49. Fires it out. That's a great tackle at the 40.
Boy, this is just outstanding execution by the quarterback and the wide receiver. I mean, you look at that throw and you think, oh my gosh, what are you doing? You're throwing that into coverage. But only he knows the confidence that he has in his wide receiver to have the ability to come down with the football for that first down. That's big time there between the quarterback and the wide receiver.
Grabs a pitch, looking for the corner. He's all the way. Touchdown. The halfback got the carry and weaved through that defense for a score.
He found some daylight and took off for six.
And he tacks on the extra point.
Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
Let's check in on the SEC, where speed reigns. And for Pierce, he ended up with two touchdown runs in the game. The Gators take it by six. In another game, an update now from Starkville. And for Mississippi State, they've lost two in a row.
All right, Reese, back to our game.
LSU ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today.
And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. From their own 27-yard line, second down. They'll bring him down around the 29-yard line. Gains his way to the 39-yard line.
He gets another set of downs and, more importantly, opens up a whole host of play-calling possibilities for the coaching staff.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 39-yard line.
Caught with room to work. He gets hit out of bounds around the 44-yard line.
Around the 42-yard line. The Volunteers always have guys that are near the top statistically, and that's no exception today. We're really looking forward to watching this kid play. From the 42-yard line, it's first down.
Mike 18.
slings it. And they make the stop at the 35. Short game. This is the eighth play of this drive. There was some movement on the line. That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
So the penalty makes it first and 15. He's out of bounds at the 24-yard line. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
It's the ninth play of the drive.
Watch 18. 18's the mic. Ready? Round 50.
He's going to try and scramble. He's taken down
right around the 24-yard line.
So we're looking at another third down here. Quick throw out to the receiver. Tackle made at about the 15-yard line.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
This is the 11th play of this drive. They try to get a head start there.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
So the penalty will make it first and 15. Down at the 21-yard line. The D lineman wasn't letting anyone by him that time.
And the big fella did a heck of a job plugging up the hole where that play was supposed to go.
Second down at 16 to go. Ball on the 21. Fires out quickly to the tailback. They'll knock him down for a loss. That'll be a loss of one.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
They line up for another third down, and they've had no problem converting their first two. Left biting his tailback, and they get him in the backfield for a loss. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. There's a little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call.
Just a mental lapse, but it's going to cost him 5 yards.
The kick is up. It's got the distance. And he just drilled it from long range. A quick update now. Here's Reese.
The Razorbacks came into the game ranked 16th and hoping to make a huge jump in the rankings. Now the question is, how far will they fall? The upset is complete. The Wolverines win it by 14. In other games, the Sooners take the field as the second-ranked team in the country. We've got a tight one going on here. The Sooners are out front 7-3.
You can never overlook any team any week in college football.
Wow.
Tennessee is lining up to kick this one off. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The Tigers' offense, I thought, answered the doubters big time with an impressive opening drive, and they got on the board first.
Yeah, when you're in a hostile environment, you want to play with a little bit of a chip on your shoulder and just show people that you're not intimidated by the environment. We sure did that first time out.
LSU is up by four.
He's got an opening. And he's taken down
right around the 48-yard line.
He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
First and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line. Credit those two defenses in that first quarter, or blame the offenses for a lack of production. 7-3, LSU. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two.
He has some room. He's at the 30, the 10. Touchdown, Tigers.
And he adds the extra point. A short two-play, 75-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Boy, that is scoring in a hurry. This offense is looking more and more explosive.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime.
He's scrambling. Gets past the tackler, and he's sacked.
You know, I don't think the offense did a very good job of recognizing the corner blitz. The quarterback's got to do a better job of using his eyes to recognize the blitz, and also it would have helped if the wide receiver would have been pointing like crazy at the corner, letting the quarterback know, hey, we've got a blitz here. That's time is a big-time miscommunication by the offense.
From their own 24-yard line, second down.
He's on the run, runs with it, and he's got room. He's tackled around the 30-yard line.
Tosses out to the tailback on the screen.
He's at midfield, knocked out of bounds at the 50-yard line.
A pass like that is so hard to defend because the defender doesn't have a great play on the ball unless it's underthrown. It's all based on connection between the quarterback and his receiver.
First and 10, ball on the 50-yard line.
He's tackled at about the 41.
Man left, man left. Four down, four down. Watch 18 for Mike.
Run on. Red 88. Run on. Red 88.
Flags are all over the place, and they'll blow it dead.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
Second and 6. Ball on the 46-yard line.
You can't block me.
Mike 18. Mike 18. Red! Red! Red!
Now he tries to buy some time. There's a fumble. It's picked up by the defense.
That's a big break for this defense.
You know, this offense just can't afford to be getting hit with a turnover bug. They need to hold on to the football.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. He fights forward to about the 46.
About a yard there on the quarterback keeper.
Boy, the senior linebacker's experience really showed on that run. He sniffed it out perfectly and made the tackle.
From their own 46-yard line, second down. They'll spread the field with five wide. And down he goes, right around the 40. He scrambles. They'll bring him down at the 17-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 17. Immediately tackled. Nice run there as they work the outside. So he holds on to it and gets a good 5 yards. The Tigers taking their first time out of the half. The Volunteers lost a player earlier, and Herbie, this is a big blow to this team. Doesn't look like he's going to play any more football today.
2 minutes left in the half.
He's scrambling. Decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown. He makes the PAT. LSU to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout.
Three, nine.
Kill, kill, kill!
Got a three.
Scrambling around. Slides down to the ground. Well, they didn't get the first down, but it was still a pretty good run by the quarterback.
He made a good decision to take off there.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. He's going to try and scramble. Tackle around the 37-yard line. And he's hit immediately.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
From the 47-yard line, first down. Handoff on the draw. He tackles him for a loss. Five wide. And that one's incomplete. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 37.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
throw. And he hits him hard at the 47-yard line. They couldn't get the first down.
Well, here they were hoping to get a few extra yards after the catch. Give the defense credit. They held him short.
Brooks is set back, ready to punt. He'll probably try to pooch this one into the corner. Oh, excellent punt. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. LSU's team, when you look at them, I think they got to be happy with how versatile they can be, because they do have a star that is not having a star-type game right now, and yet they got the lead here. We're almost halfway.
Yeah, I think they've really shown their versatility as an offense. To think that we would be sitting here close to this first half being over, and to see that their go-to wide receiver is not putting up these big numbers, and yet they still have the lead, just tells you a lot about their coaching, the in-game adjustments, and the way the rest of the teammates of this receiver stepped up.
And that'll do it for the first half. Still plenty of football to be played. The Tigers with an 18-point cushion. All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 25. The Tigers continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He has some room. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. And they make the stop at the 44-yard line. Let's see now how the defense responds to giving up the gain on the run. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. He's in for the score, and they're back in it. Kirk, that was a beautiful pass and a nice catch.
Well, this is one of those plays you just sit back and admire. The quarterback threw the ball perfectly, and again, the speed of the receiver is the difference in this play.
Splits the uprights with the extra point. Tennessee lines up for the kickoff. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So they're just about set to get the game going again. Carries the ball for a nice game. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. With five wide receivers. Oh,
Oh, and he had some steam on that throw.
Brought down at the 33-yard line.
The offense didn't appear to be in sync on that series.
The secondary decided to drop back into coverage here. There was nobody open for the quarterback to deliver the ball to. Good job by the D.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. He gets hit out of bounds.
Around the 31-yard line.
They moved the ball very effectively on their last drive, which ended with a touchdown. The defense has been talking it over on the sideline, trying to make some corrections. Let's see if they can stop them this time.
And it was a really nice drive, too, Brad. The quarterback got into a nice rhythm and did a good job of picking apart the defense.
The 40-yard line. First down. He's taken down at the 27-yard line.
And he's got room here.
What a play, and that is first and goal.
Two score game, and they can cut that down here if they can get this one in the end zone.
The 7-yard line. They'll lose a yard on that quarterback keeper. Gains about 5 yards on the run. Big play here for both teams. It's third and goal from the two. They come out on an empty backfield. Now he's scrambling. Breaks a tackle and he'll score. Touchdown.
That is great. Tough football right there. Getting down to the goal line and just punching it in.
And he tacks on the extra point.
The Volunteers had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup.
He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Tennessee's playing much better on the defensive side of the ball here in the third quarter.
Well, Brad, I think what I've seen is they were just doing too much in the first half. They've streamlined their attack, and I think it's made it a little bit easier for their players to understand what to do, and they're playing a lot faster.
Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive.
LSU is up 4. He's taken down at the 40. From their own 40-yard line, it's first down.
Outside after a nice pickup.
He gets 4, maybe 5 yards on the counter.
Bring it! Like 10!
has some daylight. At the 30, to the 20, the 10. Touchdown, LSU. And he converts the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 28-yard line.
Tennessee's come out of the locker room after the halftime, and they got a whole different approach going here offensively.
Yeah, I think the one thing I'm recognizing is just more about the execution. I think they're doing a good job of sticking to the fundamentals of their game plan, but I think they're doing a better job of executing that game plan, and it's helping them out.
Feeds it to the back. Runs outside for a nice gain. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. He might have a chance. He's at midfield. Gains his way to the 46-yard line. Works the right side. It's not over yet, folks. We head to the fourth quarter. LSU's in front by 11. As we resume play here in quarter number four. And he's tackled right away. From the 29-yard line. First down. The middle for a nice game. First down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. They go with the run, and he's taken down behind the line. Loss of two by the halfback. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Tackle around the 13-yard line.
Did you see how quickly he was able to get into the backfield and make that tackle? Not many guys that big can move that fast.
From the 13-yard line, it's third down. There's a strike complete. They bring him down in the backfield.
And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. The lineman got a little ahead of the snap count. Here's the call.
Just a mental lapse, but it's going to cost him 5 yards.
It's fourth down. So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. He gets it up, and the field goal is good. Tennessee to kick. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. I have a feeling we haven't seen the end of the fireworks today.
I think it's pretty obvious they've got to keep the ball on the ground here. Take as much time off the clock as possible.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Slings it, and he's immediately tackled. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Intercept it, and they'll return this one all the way. He'll take it all the way for the touchdown. All right, guys, crucial 2-point conversion. They'll try to tie this thing up. He scrambled. Get the two. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
The Sooners were ranked number 2, and after that performance, everyone knows why. And for Oklahoma, they've won 2 straight. Oklahoma finishes it off 30-10.
All right, thanks, Reese. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So the offense will come back out onto the field, hoping for a little better result than that last pick six.
Brad, it's very important that this offense put that last possession behind them and just focus on trying to put together some positive plays right now and see if they can put a drive together.
They run the option, and it's the tailback who gives them an 8-yard gain on the play. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. They'll bring him down at the 40-yard line. So they complete that for about 7 yards, and they'll pick up a first down.
And how about the poise of this quarterback to locate his receiver past the sticks and get him the ball? That was a great throw.
Around the 48-yard line.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
Man left. It's first and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line. Just over 2 minutes in the game. And they get nice yardage on that run. They come out in a 5-wide set. And down he goes, around the 40-yard line. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Just
just a tremendous job by that defense, and their coordinator did a super job there to keep it this close in this ballgame. And now the offense has got a chance to win it.
Atkins looking to knock one inside the 20 here on this punt.
Tigers coaching staff, Kirk, do they start wondering, hey, are we going to have trouble with our star player after the struggles he had today?
Well, I think the coaching staff's got to be happy that this team was able to win the football game and overcome the fact that their star player didn't have a great game. But I think making adjustments and changing the game plan because their star didn't deliver, I think that would be a big mistake.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.